Hello friends, welcome to the session on School as an Agency of Education. School as a medium for education. School is treated as the most suitable, active and formal agency of education. The word school has been derived from the Greek word skol, that means leisure. It was introduced as a concept in ancient Greece to utilize leisure time in a systematic way. But now, this concept has changed to a prime time activity. Now, it is an essential investment field on which the entire future of an individual depends. Formal school has emerged out of the demand for education. It provides a structured education and promotes a child's mental and psychological growth. Apart from academics, a child will also learn other important life skills such as teamwork, good manners, unity, sharing and responsibility. By allowing children to learn in a school setting while they are young, they can be molded into good, responsible and hardworking individuals. The role of school in child development begins as early as preschool and continues through a child's life. The role of school in child development. Some consider parents to be a child's first teacher, while teachers are their second parents. When kids begin their preschool or kindergarten education, children are in a way handed over to trained teachers and are ideally nourished and bestowed with support and good teaching by these professionals. Early education in school is the key in creating the right environment for a child's educational success. Children will learn habits and patterns that they retain in later years, and if teachers and parents can establish positive learning skills and social interaction skills early on, children will have the right tools to help them achieve success in the future. School also provides a structured setting where children can learn about rules and regulations, as well as where they can learn how to behave positively in group settings. How school affects a child's development? Academic potential. Ideally, the school's role is to bring each student to his or her maximum academic potential. While its effectiveness may vary from school to school, it's not enough to teach the ABCs and 1, 2, 3s and leave the rest for the child to learn. A significant amount of schoolwork throughout the grades is dedicated to help children become expert problem solvers and solution seekers. Social skills. Development of social skills is another important function of school. The school plays an important role in helping children learn to interact positively with their peers and teachers. They learn about healthy relationship skills and develop them further through interactions, both in the classroom and on playground. The emotional and social maturity of a child provides the important underpinnings for child development in all other areas. Children spend a large part of their day at school, and it's vital that a school's curriculum is designed to help its students form solid social relationships and friendships. Character building and self-concept. Character building is not an alternative to academic achievement, but rather an essential adjunct of it. Just as the school provides lessons on reading, writing and arithmetic, from the very beginning it also focuses on helping kids learn about compassion, respect, empathy and integrity. At first, it begins with basic lessons like raise your hand to speak and keep your hands to yourself. Later, it develops into argumentative debates about moral and social issues. By the time a child covers high school, he should have a fairly firm grasp on his own beliefs, values and how he views himself. If he feels that he is an inept communicator, it is unlikely he'll pursue a career in law or public speaking. It is this understanding of who he is and what he values that will help determine his academic, professional and personal pursuits. Objectives and functions of school. A school has various responsibilities towards the students, the society and therefore the nation. The main objectives that a school focuses on from different points of view are objectives of a school towards the individual, which includes problem solving skills. By studying subjects like mathematics, physics and chemistry, students develop an aptitude for solving intellectual problems. They develop their reasoning skills and critical thinking. These skills enable a student to resolve other problems, be it in academics or in life, and think clearly about them and find the right solutions. Linguistic ability and numerical ability. Certain subjects like language and mathematics are necessary throughout life. A basic grasp of language is indispensable in getting through life. The school not only enables a person to read, write and speak more than one language, but also teaches him or her essential communication skills. In addition to language, school also teaches mathematics, which also forms an essential part of day-to-day life. Broadening horizons. The school can introduce a child to a multitude of opportunities. Field trips and interactive projects let a child to try out new things. While each different subject in school gives her a taste of what could await him or her in the future. All the experiences develop a child's interest, build self-esteem, and shape the goal of her later academic and professional life. Improve communication skills, social skills, and teamwork. In a classroom environment and by doing working groups, a person learns how to effectively communicate with his peers and to interact with individuals as well as groups. Group assignments and activities promote team spirit and mutual respect. Develop a work ethic. A continuous system of learning ensures that a student must be meticulous in his or her schoolwork. Sufficient effort has to be put up for daily studying, homework, assignments, project, and for examinations. This teaches a student to work hard and on a systematic basis. Teach time management. There are multitudes of activities a student can engage in school, and there are also a multitude of subjects a student has to study. Due to this, a student learns to prioritize his tasks and through trial and error understands the amount of time that has to be spent on an activity. This teaches a student the valuable virtue of time management. Inculcate persistence, inquisitiveness. Through the vast nature of the curriculum, a student is exposed to a wide range of subjects. This causes him or her to think in different ways, and naturally doubts arise as a part of the process. So, a student becomes inquisitive and either seeks help from his teachers or learns to find out the answers to his or her questions on his or her own. Objectives of school towards society and nation. Inculcation of civic and social responsibility is the first objective of school towards society and nation. School can be considered as an extended family, and a child learns his duties towards his family, his school, and towards society in general. As he or she is a part of a community, he or she learns that through collective effort. Also, through activities like social awareness campaigns, fundraisers, and traffic management, a student can contribute to the society in his or her own small way. Training for leadership. The leadership quality of the individual is developed when she or he participates in all spheres of activities available in school. Situation arises where she or he has to take charge and direct the group she or he is involved in. Through such situations, a person is able to recognize and improve his or her leadership qualities. National integration. We are living in a country which is diverse in respect of color, caste, language, social status, and lifestyle. A school is the first place that a child begins to understand this diversity by interacting with children from different social strata, each with their own language, values, and mannerisms. Education trains people for a world with unity while keeping the beauty of diversity. Therefore, school as an agency for education is an essential part of the life of a child. It plays an important part in the betterment of the society as well as the nation. structure of school curricular learning. School offers a structured form of learning. A student undergoes education usually within a classroom and sometimes outside of it for a specific number of hours. Most schools have a time duration of 6 to 7 hours, with each subject allocated a specific duration called a period. The duration of a period may vary from 30 minutes to 1 hour depending on the school and the subject. There are also long and short breaks between the periods for allowing the students to cool off. Curriculum refers to all the courses of study offered by an education institution. A major part of it is formed by the languages, mathematics, science and social sciences. There are also other parts of the curriculum like physical education, work experience, library, etc. Majority of the school hours are dedicated to curriculum education. The subjects taught depend on the curriculum and the grade of the student. The most common of these are language. One or two languages are taught depending on the grade of the student. Usually, English and a national or regional language are taught. The purpose behind teaching language is that students are able to communicate and express themselves through speech and also writing in an effective manner. Science. Learning of science initially comprises of a general introduction to science and scientific practices. It contains knowledge from physics, chemistry, biology, environmental studies, etc. In later grades, each part of science is given further attention and streams like physics, chemistry and biology forms individual subjects. Mathematics. Mathematics is a subject that is taught in every class right from kindergarten, where a child learns to count, to its more specific branches like geometry, trigonometry and algebra. In higher classes, more advanced mathematics comprising of calculus, statistics, number theory, probability, etc. may be taught depending on the curriculum and the need of other subjects like physics. Social science. Social science is an important part of the school curriculum as it makes a student aware of his rights, responsibilities and duties. It inculcates within him a sense of nationality and also an understanding of the world in general. Geography gives a student an idea about the different countries of the world and also different parts of his or her own country. She or he learns about the features of a location such as climate, population, density, soil type, rivers flowing within a region, rainfall and much more. History makes a student aware of the heritage of his or her nation and the civilizations that existed before his or her time. It gives him or her an idea on the origin and diversity of other countries. It also gives a student an idea about the wars that have been fought in the past and their consequences. Civics and environmental studies make a student aware of his or her responsibilities towards the society and the environment. It gives him or her an insight into the constitution of a nation, his or her rights and duties towards the country as a citizen. She or he also learns about the various forms and the functions of the government. Work experience. Students undergo training in vocational skills like gardening, soldering and crafts through work experience. Although it is not given as much time as the major subjects, it forms an important part of the curriculum. In work experience, a student learns through hands-on experience rather than theoretical knowledge. Physical education. Physical education also has a specific number of hours dedicated to it each week. This ensures that a student is healthy physically and fit, as a healthy mind resides in a healthy body. Sports like football, cricket, basketball, badminton and a number of other sports are taught and played as a part of physical education. Hidden curriculum. Additionally, social attitudes and habits are taught that produce people who fit into the social, political and economic statuses in a society. These lessons that prepare individuals to accept the requirements and expectations of adult life are what sociologists call the hidden curriculum. For example, in addition to teamwork and competition, students quickly learn that society seeks out for the best individual, whether that person has the best score on a test or the best performance at a spelling bee. Even collaborative activities focus on a leader, and team sports single out the one most valuable player. So, the hidden curriculum in this case involves the promotion of expertise in an individual. Co-curricular and extracurricular activities. Co-curricular activities are those activities which have indirect reference to actual instructional work that goes on in the classroom. These activities are performed within school hours. They are not directly a part of the curriculum and are to be performed by all students and under the guidance of teachers. Different co-curricular activities for schools. Physical activities. Activities like games, mass drill, cycling, gardening, etc. are organized at school. These activities can help in physical development. Literary activities. Activities like telling stories, writing, singing community songs, performing a play, etc. are organized as part of co-curricular activities. School assembly. All the students in a school get a chance to meet once a day together. The school programs are announced by the teacher in school assembly. Social service. Different service activities like cleaning school, watering plants, cleaning roads, and helping the poor people at their need inculcate a helping mentality within a student. Festivals and observances. The school observes different festivals like Independence Day, Republic Day, Children's Day, Teachers' Day, etc. These activities develop the leadership qualities of students. The children learn teamwork, social work, and sacrificing individual interest for peer group or society through co-curricular activities. An extracurricular activity is defined as a program or out-of-class activity supervised and/or financed by the school, which provides non-curriculum related learning and character building experience. Extracurricular activities are voluntary, not part of the regular school curriculum, and are not graded and do not earn credits, but it gives a chance to the student to bring out his or her hidden skills and talents. Different extracurricular activities. Clubs. Students can be a part of different clubs like music club, debate club, environment club, karate club, and a variety of other clubs. Such activities offer students an opportunity to learn a skill that is not in the curriculum in which they have an interest. It helps a student diversify her or his interests and also form hobbies and friendships. Also, students can eventually join the school team and represent the school in competitions. Adventure camps. Through adventure camps and activities like scouts and guides, interested students are exposed to a number of outdoor activities like trekking, parasailing, and camping. These activities offer students a new experience and an opportunity to meet new people with similar interests. Excursions. By going on excursions, students are able to visit many places of historical or scientific importance. They could also visit places known for their scenic beauty. Such activities can satiate a student's desire for travel and seeing new things. Benefits of co-curricular and extracurricular activities. Schools provide a plethora of extracurricular activities. Some occur before school, some after school, and a few may even take place during the weekends. While some parents are a bit dubious about their children participating in extracurricular activities, these activities actually bring with the students many benefits. Allowing a child to get involved in extracurricular activities at school is a wise choice, and it can be very important in helping them to develop many working skills. Some of the benefits of extracurricular and co-curricular activities are learning new things. Being involved in extra and co-curricular activities affords a student the opportunity to learn new things and attain new skills. A student can learn how to sing, play an instrument, playing a sport, to paint then many more things through extracurricular activities, learning time management and prioritizing. One great benefit of a child being involved in extracurricular activities is that they will learn about time management and prioritizing things in their life, getting involved in diverse interests. Getting involved in extracurricular activities also allows students to get involved in diverse interests. These activities allow them to explore and improve in various interests that they may have. Learning about long-term commitments. Students learn about long-term commitments when they are involved in extracurricular activities. When they join in one of the activities or clubs, they commit themselves to that activity for a stipulated period of time. Learning to take on commitments is important in adult life too, and extracurricular activities teach a child this important lesson. Making a contribution. Extracurricular activities provide choice for a child to make his or her own contribution in some way. This is important in their growth as a person. Raises self-esteem. Involving in extracurricular activities helps a child to enhance his or her self-esteem. Everyone wants to find something that they are really good at, and extracurricular activities provide them with a way that they can get involved in something and really shine, giving their self-esteem a boost. Learning to develop perspectives. Extracurricular activities provide an additional space for a student to initiate and develop his or her own perspectives on the activities and the related rules that they involve. Let me summarize the topic. In this unit, we have looked at the role of school as an agency of education. School forms the most established and structured form of education, and it is responsible for the development of a child intellectually, socially, and aids in the character development process. We have discussed the primary objectives and functions of school and its responsibilities to the individual, the society, and the nation. We have also identified the different forms of learning offered in school and discussed the main features and objectives of curricular education. Furthermore, we have also identified the differences between extracurricular and co-curricular activities and discussed their benefits. Through this unit, we have seen the importance of school in the education of an individual and its contribution to the betterment of the society and ultimately the development of the nation. Now, you can try to answer the questions listed here. How does a school affect the development of a child? What are the main objectives of the school towards an individual? What is curricular education? What is hidden curriculum? What are the differences between extracurricular and co-curricular activities? Now, you can refer the books for further understanding. History of Education in India by Sharma RN and Sharma RK, published by Atlantic Publishers, New Delhi in the year 2004. Sociology of Education by Chandra SS and Rajendra Kumar Sharma, published by Atlantic Publishers, New Delhi in the year 2004. Education in India by Rao RK, published by Kalpas Publication, New Delhi in the year 2005. Thank you for watching this program. Hope that you have enjoyed this session. We can meet again with another topic. Have a nice day.